Hi, I'm Jenny Brocky. Tonight on Insight, couples with a big age difference.
When I found out how older I was, there was a little bit of a shock.
What did you think about the age difference when you realised it was 19 years?
I thought, sweet.
My friends were shocked, absolutely mortified, horrified. A lot of them thought perhaps I had a bit of daddy issues.
Even when we met, we knew we would have to have a conversation about eventually we might not be in the same place at the same time in our life.
I checked my social media and went, oh my God, Aretha's died? And he said, oh, really? Aretha who? And I said, oh, Aretha Franklin? And he went, oh, is she a friend of yours?
Like most normal families. We have a lot of fun together, there's lots of love. My husband and I, we're equals. We're pretty much a normal family. I'm Evie, I am 32. My husband is Pete and he is 63. And we have a son, Thomas, who is 4.5. There is 31 years age difference between my husband and I.
We do gel very well, you know, between us, because Evie is more mature than her age and I'm a little bit of a kid at heart and I don't want to be 63. So we fit in pretty well.
No, not the shark! My shark! Together as a family, like most normal families, we go to the park, we go to the beach, we go out and have lunch together, just, you know, your normal everyday things. The only difference might be is that, you know, we might get assumptions because of Pete's age. I remember we had one particular occasion where we were at a cafe and someone said to me, oh, that's very nice of you to take your dad out for lunch. And I made a joke of it and I kissed Pete and, you know, and they were a bit like, what? You know, like, we make a joke of it because for us it doesn't bother us. But we're quick to correct those people quite gently.
I love Thomas like there's no tomorrow. Having a child is definitely the best thing that's happened to us. It does play on my mind. I do sometimes worry about the fact that he may be bullied because I am much older than sort of his friends' fathers. I can expect the kids going, oh yeah, that's Thomas's dad, he's like 400 years old, you know. There's not a lot I can do about it. We just do the best we can, try and stay in fit and healthy as I can for as long as I can and just tackle it that way.
Evie, you and your husband Pete met at church 7 years ago. How old were you when you met?
I was around about 25.
How old were you, Pete?
I would have been 56, I think.
Were you attracted to him straight away?
Not initially, no. More as a friend. But my attraction grew as time went on, as we got to know each other a lot better.
Who introduced you to Evie, Pete?
Ironically, it was actually my ex-wife. She was living with me at the time and she came home from church and said, oh, I've just met this lovely girl at church, Pete, you're going to fall in love with her. And I went, oh, yeah, whatever. Yeah.
Did you think that Evie might be interested in a relationship with you?
Not initially, but not all that long after, we could both feel that there was something there that wasn't just a friendship.
And what was the attraction for you?
Look, I found her to be very honest and to just love life, and she had a wicked sense of humour, which I have, so we gelled pretty quick.
Had either of you had a relationship with a big age gap before?
My first wife was actually 20 years younger than me, but she was actually quite young when I met her. She was only about 18, and that was like 20 years ago, so.
Evie, what's the attraction being with somebody more than 30 years older?
When we first met, I was quite settled in my career. I was ready to settle down, you know, for marriage, for kids. And the attraction really was Pete's personality more than anything. I was actually talking to a friend of mine the other day and I was saying to her, had it been 5 years before I met Pete, I wouldn't have looked at him twice. But I think it was, you know, that we had a lot in common. We liked the same movies. We liked doing the same things.
What sort of things do you notice with the age gap within the relationship?
I think Pete's not that great with technology. So one of the things that we do notice is that Pete's got his own personal IT guru which is quite handy for him.
That's you.
Yes. Sometimes we notice that there's a difference in music. So if we go somewhere, you know, there might be a little bit of disagreements over what we listen to. But aside from that, there's not many differences.
Hmm. Leocadia, you're married to Des. What's the age difference between the two of you?
34 years.
You met at church too.
Yes.
Yeah? What is this with church? When you were 19, you started dating when you were 24. What was the attraction for you in a man 34 years older?
Initially, it was Des's intellect. Des has a doctorate in philosophy and history. And at the time, I was studying archaeology and criminology at Monash. And it was very much an intellectual conversation that progressed to a friendship. I got married to somebody else. That didn't work out quite well. And Des was a beautiful support for me through that. And the relationship progressed and we just fell in love.
And Des, what about you? What was the attraction for you?
As Leocadia said, the interaction was something that I found interesting. I remember we were together at an archaeological site, and it turns out that we're having a great argument about the origins and why this place was disappeared and so on. And she came at it from one perspective and I came at it from a totally different perspective. And neither of us necessarily solved the problem, but it was the interaction, I think, that tends to bond you together, I guess.
Had either of you had relationships with a big age gap prior to this?
No.
No, my first boyfriend was my first husband and that was a very small age gap. It was only 6 years, so it's very different to being in a relationship with Des.
How did your peers react to you getting together?
My friends were shocked, absolutely mortified, horrified, didn't know what to do with me. Do we still go out? Does this mean? Are you going to get married? Very, very, very tense.
So how did that play out? You say they were shocked. What happened?
I still have a few friends that have maintained that connection that were very accepting of Des, and they still are. They love him very much. So there's about 3 to 4 friends that I have that are very close to us, but I've definitely lost a huge circle of friends.
And why do you think that was?
I think it's a bit confronting for them. A lot of them thought perhaps I had a bit of daddy issues, so they were like, what's going on there? Or they just honestly did not know how to interact with Des at all. They thought maybe they were talking to their father or an older brother, so they found it a bit strange.
You both decided to move to London for a while. Why?
We had both finished teaching degrees at that point and decided that England would be a nice place to trial out our teaching careers. And I think we both needed a bit of a fresh start and break from everybody. So Des went first and took me a bit of time, but I ended up packing a suitcase and going as well, and we settled and started officially dating and just was away from everything.
Away from everything.
Yeah. Yeah.
Russell, you and your partner Zach have been together 18 months. How did you meet?
We met online, which I guess is pretty modern in how it's done these days.
And what were your circumstances when you got together?
I've had 3 relationships in my life. This is my 3rd relationship. I've been married to a woman for 25 years and I came out when I was 48 and had a 3-year relationship with a man and then met Zach.
Now, did you know how old each of you were when you met?
No. I guess our profiles didn't have our ages on them, but clearly he was younger than me. But I guess I wasn't aware how much younger than me he was.
How old are you, Zach?
I'm 19.
And how old are you, Russell?
Nearly 53, 52.
What was the connection for you two? What did you connect over?
He was very into music. And I found that's how we did connect in a way. And he has had all these different experiences, like traveling the world. He's been to places overseas. And that was always something that drew me to him as well.
Why? Had you done that?
No, it's quite the opposite. I've never been outside of Melbourne apart from this year. So just hearing about his stories, about his travels, was just very fascinating to me.
Russell, what did you like about Zach?
I guess I was attracted to his freshness, and he has a very non-judgmental attitude, and I guess I'd felt a lot of judgment previously, so I was very attracted to the way he looked at life and the world.
What sort of judgment had you felt?
I grew up in a country town. I've struggled with my sexuality, so I didn't come out till I was 48. I found that a very difficult time. My first gay relationship was quite difficult, so I guess I found a lot of difficulty finding myself, and I was, I guess, attracted to somebody who was not looking at people with any judgment and had a very open-minded attitude.
And how long ago had you come out, Zach? Was that something you bonded over?
Yeah, so the first time I ever told someone I was gay was when I was 14. So it was still pretty fresh when I met Russell. I was still new to the whole gay community. I'd never really met anyone who was in my community. And I definitely think that is why we connected as well, because we were both still very new to that side of the world, at least.
What was it like when you found out how old each other were?
Well, I was surprised because, I mean, I thought he was maybe mid-40s. And it's not like a bad surprise. I was like, oh, you look pretty amazing for your age.
I certainly would have preferred it if he was in his 20s. And I wouldn't have expected someone who was 18 to be pursuing me. So, yeah, I guess I was disappointed, if that's the right word.
Disappointed?
Well, yeah. It makes it a huge age difference, yeah. Like, 33 years is a lifetime.
Well, it's 1 year less than these two.
Totally. I'm glad to meet them.
Are there times that you notice big differences between the two of you, given the age gap?
Definitely. There was one moment where he mentioned Aretha Franklin.
Yeah.
We
woke up one morning, it was the day that Aretha had died, and we woke up and I checked my social media. I went, oh my God, Aretha's died? And he said, oh, really? Aretha who? And I said, oh, Aretha Franklin? And he went, oh, is she a friend of yours? Oh, no.
It was very embarrassing.
But I guess I see that now, like that was in the very early days, I see that now as, obviously there's an age difference there, but it's also like a lack of just pop culture that he doesn't know who a lot of musical artists are, so. But it definitely makes for a funny story.
Yeah. I definitely wasn't exposed to a lot of that growing up, so I guess that's why as well.
Have you listened to Aretha since?
Yes.
Yeah. And do you understand now why it was such a big deal?
Yes, I've listened to so much more music because of him.
What about financially, the difference between the two of you?
Well, there's a huge difference, clearly, financially. I'm very set in my career. I've recently bought an apartment. I'm talking about long service leave and my mortgage and things, which is a very different thing to what a 19-year-old would be thinking about. Yeah. Zach's in a very different position financially.
Yeah, because I'm a full-time student, and at the time I met him, I was unemployed. I wasn't working at all. It was definitely different when we started going out and we'd go out with friends or we'd go out for dinner, and there was definitely problems with that and differences. And it was only recently that I did start working, and that changes everything for us. It changes the way, the place where our relationship will go.
And you live at home with your parents still?
Yeah, so part of the time I'll still live with my mum and my sister, and part of the time I'm with Russell.
Philippa, thanks for joining us from Byron Bay. You're 41. How old is your husband, Rye?
Rye is 22.
And how did you two meet?
We met doing a theatre play together.
Yeah, that's right.
We rehearsed for 3 months, I think, and we became friends and slowly got to know each other better and better. And I was coming out of my first marriage, and it was a really tough time, and we just had a really good time together as a cast, and we got to know each other better and better, and one day I just realised that I had fallen in love.
You were 37. How old did you think he was?
Yeah. I thought he was 28, maybe 29, somewhere around there.
And Rye, how old did you think Philippa was?
I didn't think she was... I thought she was probably about 30 years old or 32 or something around there.
You two are in a tiny minority of couples where the woman is considerably older than the man. How did you both react when you found out there was this 19-year difference between the two of you?
When I found out how old I was, I basically fell off my chair where we were sitting. There was a little bit of a shock. I remember driving home and thinking, oh my God, like, what's going on? But it didn't change anything. It didn't change the way I felt for I. It didn't change him as a person. It didn't change the connection we had.
Rye, what did you think about the age difference when you realised it was 19 years?
I thought, sweet. No. It was a bit confronting at the start. I did the modern age thing and did a bit of snooping around on Facebook before we actually hooked up for the first time. And I realised that she, was in a marriage and that she's got kids. So immediately I kind of knew where she was at, you know, that she was a responsible woman, probably had a few assets and things going on in her life. But when we met, it literally felt like there was a couple of years age gap. Like, we just met at this level that was just unbelievable. I mean, you don't choose love, you know? You don't choose your soulmate. They just rock up in your life, just like Philippa did, and here we are.
Had you gone out with older women before?
Well, no, before meeting Philippa, I was underage, so I'm not sure anyone would have been too interested, but... No, Philippa was my first.
Yeah, I was his first older woman, not first woman, which helped.
Yes.
What was it like mixing with one another's friends?
It was definitely probably one of the most interesting parts, sometimes not so positive. Mm. I felt like there was a lot of judgment, you know, from all these elderly married... Not elderly, but, like, married couples who've been established, you know. Sorry.
No, you meant older.
But,
that's
yes, like older than me couples. But yeah, a lot of them have come around, but there's probably a small group of three or four that I actually do really appreciate as friends, and the rest are just acquaintances.
And Philippa, what about Rye's friends? How did you get on with them?
Well, Rye is really, really close to his family, and Rye's sister's basically his best friend, and then there's a few other crew around there. We've had so much fun together, and Rye's friends are on a whole different level than a normal 22-year-olds. And I have never had any problems at all with these friends. They've all been super cool.
Philippa, how did your family react to this relationship?
Mum was not happy. When she found out what happened, she said, I'm going to fly out to Australia, I'm going to help you move house. This is after the separation. Mum was really attached. And that, too, to my ex-partner. I mean, after 16 years, of course, you know, that's often the case. Mum came and stayed with us for 10... Well, she was supposed to be there for 2 weeks. And I think after 7 days, I sent Mum home. I realised quickly that Mum basically came to destroy us.
She was not easy.
Oh, my gosh, she put so much pressure on you. Right, it was unbelievable.
Why do you think she did that?
I think she was very worried for my future, worried for my finances. I came out of our divorce and I managed to buy myself, buy a house for me and the kids. And Mum got this idea in her head that Rye was going to come and he was going to try to take my money. And she could not look past that.
How did you feel about your mother's reaction?
I didn't talk to my mum for 6 months, pretty much. Yeah, I put Mum on a plane back to Sweden and I said, sorry, can't deal with this.
And Rye, how did you react to that?
When she went on the plane, I was like, sweet. we had a really tough time at the house, because even me and Philippa just had so much pressure on the relationship.
Oh, gosh.
We were arguing every single day, you know, just about the smallest little things, you know, because we just had her mom just living there, and it was just putting so much pressure on the relationship. It was just
it almost broke us up, you know. Yeah. It took us to, like, breaking point. And once she left, we had a bit of breathing space and kind of put the pieces back together and really kind of bonded a lot stronger, actually. It helped us.
Took a long time, though. It like, that rocked us for literally a year. It's like, wow, maybe we're not right for each other. And yes, we have this age gap and you know, what are we actually doing in this relationship? There was a lot of back and forth in that year, and that was really, really tough. Really, really tough.
He'd had kids and he had a granddaughter, and he couldn't give me that ultimately. So we ended up breaking up. Our lives were totally at different stages and we wanted different things moving forward.
Des, you asked Leocardia to marry you, but before you did that, you weighed up the situation and whether it would work.
Yeah.
How did you weigh that up? What did you do?
It was a bit difficult on Leocardia, but we had a wall that was a full blackboard. And I had been teaching Greek history, and so I used the goddesses of ancient Greece to actually identify different characteristics, and those characteristics work out to be some of the basic things in relationship development. And so I'd put up markers on the blackboard to see where she was at and what sort of relationship would develop between us.
So you had, I'm not quite clear on what was on this blackboard, you had a whole lot of Greek goddesses or something. Well,
they represented different aspects of human nature, let's say.
And yeah. Did you put numerical value for Leocardia on them? Or?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah,
right. It was like, oh, my God.
It was like 1, 2, 3, 4 cross.
And
I had no idea what was going on.
You didn't tell her what you were doing.
I couldn't, because then she would change. Like, she would then do something different just to be which one she would like to be.
So how did you react when you found out it was about you?
It was two different things. At first I was like, what the hell do you think you're doing? I'm not a research project. And then the second part of it was, well, I actually fit into those categories, so he's actually identified me pretty well.
And what did you find in the end, Des?
Oh, look, I found that she was really the enduring type and had very similar ways of expressing love that I had. And it was a real relief, because I could see that there was something substantial that could be built on.
Leocardia, what happened when you told your family you were engaged to Des?
I was disowned by my Greek family instantly. I received quite an interesting phone call.
What was in that phone call? What happened?
In the phone call was the disapproval of the head of the family, because my father had passed away when I was 16. So his brother stated that I was an embarrassment to my family and that I was no longer welcome in any respect. I said, that's fine, that's your decision. When I had told my mother, my brother and my sister, because we were quite tight-knit, they were not too thrilled either.
What did they say?
I do believe I was called an idiot and had the phone hung up on me.
Had you expected any of that?
My Greek family in Australia is the one that disowned me. My family in Greece, however, welcomed Des with open arms. They absolutely adore him and still maintain quite a good relationship with him. I did not expect the reaction I had from my Greek family here. I knew that my Polish side, my mum, would be a bit of hard work, but I thought that'd be much more accepting. So it did come as quite a hard knock.
What was that like for you, being rung up and told the family was disowning you?
Oh, it was horrendous. We had quite a short engagement. We decided that we wanted to get married very quickly. We'd known each other for so long, so we didn't see the point in waiting. You know, inviting the family to the wedding and having the invitations returned and having those phone calls that were quite nasty and having nobody turn up to the wedding made it awful. So, you know, at our wedding we had Des's family, so his brother and his mother, and I had nobody from my family at all. And that's where Des and I just concreted we're each other's family, and that was it.
And Des, you have three children from your previous marriage. How did they react when you told them that you decided to marry Leocadia?
The relationship was strained because the disappointment that I was as a dad was very great and intense for them.
In what way? What was the disappointment?
The disappointment for them, I guess, was that marriage is for life, and I agree with that, but in our case, I had no intention of it being otherwise, but it didn't necessarily work out that way, and it was difficult for my family to do that as they had to react in their own way, and I respect that. I respect them. I respect the way they've reacted. I miss them. My son reacted in a different way, even though it was difficult for him emotionally, but he accepted me as a dad and the decisions that I needed to make.
Did they come to the wedding?
No. And my son came to the wedding, but my daughters didn't.
And how old are your children compared to Leocadia?
79, 80, 87.
His girls are older than me.
And do you think that was part of it? Do you think that was a big part of why they reacted?
Possibly.
The way they did?
I think they were hurt. They were hurt that their dad would have a mindset to actually change the foundation of their home that they knew and loved.
Evie, how did your family react to you getting together with Pete?
My mum had an inkling and she had straight out asked me initially. And I was honest with her and said, yes, this is happening. My dad, on the other hand, he was not so great. The first thing he said to him was, you know, I don't like it. I think, you know, you're too old for her. But if you make her happy, you know, I'll leave it at that. But if you hurt her, you better learn to duck. Was basically what he said.
Typical dad, yeah.
And I just said to him, well, look, this is how it is. You know, he loves me, treats me better than anybody that I've been with, and this is how it's going to be. And you just got to get used to having him around. And now you wouldn't have known that there was that issue to start off with.
And what about for you, Pete? I mean, what was it like for you dealing with the parents, and how did your family react?
I rang Mum and I said, look, this is what's happened. And she shocked me. She said, do you know what, darling? If she makes you happy, I don't care. I'd love to meet her. And her and my mum got off really well from day one. She adored Evie. She really did. They got on so well. And she just said, if you make him happy, I don't care. There's no age gap.
Rye, after the negative reaction from Philippa's family, you decided to go on a reality television show to deal with that hostility. Why?
I was away from Philippa at the time and I was thinking about her a lot, and I saw an ad on Facebook that looked like a romantic getaway. And so I just started answering questions truthfully, you know, do you have a partner, what's your situation, what's your story? And then towards the end they asked questions about the parents and do any of the parents have a problem with the relationship? And I thought, oh, hell yeah, let me tell you about that, you know. I didn't even know what the show was about, but I just had so much to write, you know, on these answers about these parents. You know, we were very truthful in our answers towards Philippa's mom, and they really liked our stories.
The show that you went on was all about opposition to relationships. It was all about, you know, when relationships are up against opposition. Why did your parents agree to go on this show?
Because they got a paid holiday to Australia all the way from Sweden, a chance to catch up with my sister and her newborn baby, and, you know, they got to hang in Byron Bay to film this show. I think the deal sounded pretty sweet to them.
And was the deal sweet for them?
Well, no, they weren't really happy about it, and that's fair enough. It was pretty full on. The 4.5 weeks in that house was pretty hectic, but end result, again, it was worth it because we did get to talk a lot to mum and dad. And the big thing was that my parents actually had to sit down and talk to Rai because we had, you know, 14 cameras on us and they had to sit and have a conversation with Rai. And I think like, somewhere through that, and the fact that Rai was so persistent and he's sitting there, you know, saying, I love your daughter and, yeah, I want to be with her.
That's going to marry her.
Yeah, it was in the end that they came to their senses and they let Rai in. So that's really nice.
Zach, how did your family react to your relationship with Russell?
I wouldn't say they reacted in a bad way necessarily. My siblings would have been the first people to know and they would have told my mum. And
what did your mum say?
She was kind of like, oh, Zach, what are you doing? And at first I was confused and she started to show worry and concern because she didn't want me to be taken advantage of. She thought because Russell was an older man that he had some power or dominance over me. She never used those words, but I knew why she was worried, definitely.
Did you talk about that with her?
No, and that's the thing. I've never openly talked to my mum or my family in general about it, because I know that they just want me to be happy. And there are some members of my family who do get along with him. I just think there are members of my family, most of them, who aren't completely on board with the relationship.
And why do you think that is?
Maybe they struggle with seeing it as a permanent thing. Maybe because I'm 19 and it's a big age gap, they think it's not going to be a permanent thing. And I think the only way to change that mindset is just to have them see us more often together.
You're older than one of Zach's parents.
Both. I'm older than both his parents. Unfortunately, just older.
What's that like?
Unfortunate. But I can't do anything about it.
So what does it mean then for your relationship with them?
I haven't been in this position before, that I've been older than my partner's parents. I guess it makes things a little awkward, but, you know, my interactions with his dad, I feel are very warm and genuine. And, you know, his mum is polite, and then she tries and we talk.
Leocadio, what was it like for you and Des making the decision to have children?
Des wanted to have children straight away. I was always hesitant to have children. But after getting married, it was just not an issue. We just went, OK, let's give this a go. And we got pregnant pretty much straight away with our first boy, Leonidas. And then we had Christian, who was a nice little welcome surprise.
Had you had conversations together about the implications of having children, given the age gap?
I don't think really talked about the implications. I was hesitant to become a mother, but I knew that Des would be the perfect father. So I don't think with the age difference, I really thought about it at all. I knew that no matter how old Des was or is or would be, that those children, if we had children, would have the perfect father.
Evie, you wanted kids. When did you first raise it with Peach?
I think P and I started to talk about it as we got engaged. We'd had a lot of discussions and our final resolve was, well, if we're going to do this, we need to do this pretty soon after marriage.
How did the idea go down initially with Pete?
Initially, Pete was like, no, don't like kids.
Pete, why were you resistant at the time?
I think because I had led a single life for such a long time and, you know, I'd travelled extensively and I could basically do whatever I wanted, whenever I wanted. And I initially thought, I don't know if I want to really give all that up. And when we agreed and said, well, yeah, if we're going to do it, we need to do it pretty quick. And I wouldn't change anything.
Philippa, you have two children from your previous marriage. They were 5 and 8 when you got together with Rye. How did they react to the idea of a new father figure in their lives?
Well, their first meeting went so well, and they have always related to Rye as an awesome person and a fun person. Like, Rye would take them out and do fun things, and he would go out with them, like, in water and just push them on boogie boards, and, you know, we're playing on the beach. Like, it's just, yeah, they have always really appreciated Rye in their lives, and he really was, like, when he came into our lives, we've gone through quite a bit of a tough time. I mean, separation is not fun, you know, and it was very sad. Like, we all really appreciated having Rye in our family.
Rye, do you want to have kids with Philippa?
I love kids, you know, and I love the idea of having my own kids, and kids with Philippa is definitely an idea that, you know, lingers in my head. But I think we've had a few chats about it, you know. I think we might try for kids, probably not anytime super soon.
Philippa, what about you? Because you're 41 now, so talking about, you know, waiting a year or 2 years takes on a different colour when you're in your 40s as a woman.
Yeah. Look, I know what you mean, and yes, of course, there is a little element of fear there. Like, you know, what if something happens? What if I'm actually, you know, I actually can't have kids in a couple of years when I'm ready? But I also feel that, like, where we're at the moment, you know, we have so much going on in our lives. I think adding a baby into that right now would not be very sensible. Mm.
Amelia, you used to be in a relationship with a man who was 12 years older. What was that like for you?
It was good at the start. We had good fun, and we got along really well, and ultimately we were in love. But then in the longer term, it got hard, and we eventually broke up because our lives were totally at different stages and we wanted different things moving forward.
Mm, in what sort of ways? What kind of things do you think?
Well, I wanted just a suburban life with two, you know, kids and a SUV and a house. He'd had kids and he had a granddaughter, and he couldn't give me that ultimately. So we ended up breaking up. And I mean, the age difference did make probably a bit of a difference as well in our lives.
And it was an issue for you too, your age in relation to his kids. And the fact that he had a grandchild as well, yeah?
Yeah, so his daughter at the time when she had her daughter, she was 18 and I was 24. I'd been told that it would be really hard for me to have kids, and given he'd had a vasectomy, it was a really hard pill for me to swallow. You know, I wanted to have one with him one day, but how's that, you know, going to happen? And watching him with his granddaughter and his children was just really, really hard for me, because you just don't know what your future looks like and you want it to be with that person, but there just wasn't a clear picture.
Gabby, your second marriage was to a man who was 17 years younger.
Yes, he
than
was.
You. You separated after 8 years. Why?
He basically ran away from home. Yeah, I think he found that it was all too much. He found a job where he was working with other fellows who were the same age as he was, and they were going through the lad phase.
How old were you at the time?
I would have been about 40, I would say 41. I met him when he was 18 and I was 34. We were married for 8 years and had two gorgeous children who, you know, are now adults.
So you had children already, or you had children with him as
I
well?
I left my husband with... We had four children. I left my husband for the younger man, which was quite dramatic at that time. And then I went on to have a further two children with the younger partner. You know, you come to a stage in your marriage and where you're going is all very good, but the age suddenly creeps up when I myself was becoming more older, thinking older probably, more so than he was, and he was being influenced by other fellows who were his age who were all going out and partying.
How did you react then when he did want to go out and do these things? I mean, what happened to the dynamics of the relationship in terms of your behaviour?
Oh, I was totally shattered, you know, that I could see this relationship falling to pieces. I was losing him, you know, and there was also jealousy on my side because I was getting older and my female competitors were quite young, good-looking, and
so you were feeling insecure
about the situation. So it was a battle. I was always battling to keep the relationship together.
So what do you think now about relationships with age gaps?
I don't necessarily think they work. just going on my experience, I think at some stage it's going to catch up. And you do go through different stages in your life yourself. And he obviously got to that stage where he wanted something that he hadn't quite gone through it yet. You know, he'd sort of jumped a few spots rather than growing up first.
Des jokes that he's going to outlive me because he's much more fitter, you know, and there's been times where we've definitely looked at him and gone, oh, heck, what are we doing?
Des, do you think about it?
Yes, definitely. I've told Leocardia what to do with my ashes.
Rebecca, you're 34 and your partner Kevin is 61. Mm-hmm. You've been together for nearly 10 years now. You don't live together though. Why is that?
No, well, when we met, we were living in different cities. So we met in Canberra, but Kevin was in Sydney, I was in Albury. And I was in Albury because my son, when we met, was not even 2 years old. So I made a decision to keep my family and raise my family and with my ex-husband down at home. And so Kevin moved to Albury and we lived together really well and really, really compatibly as we do when we're apart. We had made the struggle to try and find some work for Kevin, but with his expertise and the culture of Albury, there wasn't the work for him.
So you've had to move to Sydney for work?
I've come back to Sydney, yes, to do work, yeah.
Mm. So how often do you see one another?
Every 2 weeks.
So Kevin drives.
Except for tonight, which is a bonus.
That's great. It's an extra.
So and Kevin, what attracted you to one another?
Oh, Kevin was a beautiful, lovely gentleman. So when I met him, I was graceful and wise and intelligent, sophisticated and incredibly respectful, emotionally mature and a sweet, kind man.
And Kevin, what about you?
She has a really good opinion of me, I guess.
She's really generous with compliments.
I was attracted to the way in which we communicated. We just started to speak and the conversation just flowed. We spoke about anything and everything. We didn't agree on everything. We were happy to not agree, but also happy to share our views and just talk about things, work through things, and it just was a conversation that just got richer and deeper and happier and continues even now.
What sort of things do you think about as Kevin gets older, Rebecca?
You tend to forget it a lot. I think it's only when I have to write my date of birth and it ends in 85 and Kevin's is 58. So I have to think about later on when I finish caring for Tobias, I have to think about where I'm going to be. And so our age, add 11 years or 10 years from now, it's going to be a different picture.
What about as you get older, Kevin, you know, as you go into your 70s, 80s, you know, and older, do you think about that and what happens with Rebecca?
I'm very aware of the possibility that as I get older, I'll be less able to do things, less able to engage. And, I mean, there are days when I think I'm missing out even now.
Have you talked about those things together? What sort of things have you discussed?
We've talked about them a bit, but also I think that we've talked about them as things that we are going to need to address over time, rather than saying well, we've got to fix idea. This is the way we're going to have to manage that.
Such as? What kinds of things?
Oh, I think, for example, I mean, when Kevin's significantly older, as Kevin once said to me that he, you know, I want to care for Kevin, but Kevin doesn't want me to be his carer. So,
Kevin, why don't you want Rebecca to be your carer, if it came to that?
I would not want our relationship to change that it was seen as being a caretaking relationship rather than our partnership, the partnership that we have.
What would that mean then for the relationship?
I don't know what that would mean. I think that it would mean changes, but I'm not sure what those changes would be.
What do you think about that, Rebecca?
It's hard to think about it because, you know, it was one of those subliminal things and a subtext that we had when we met. Like, even when we met, we knew we would have to have a conversation. And our first biggest conversation was this year about saying, look, eventually we might not be in the same place at the same time in our life. And we need to work that out. But we have a great style of deciding what's best for us and for our relationship. And I think when we have to make decisions about Kevin's ageing, then it will be the right ones when we come to it.
Mm. Have any of the rest of you thought about any of these sort of things? About getting older and what that means for your relationships?
Yeah, look, I have, because as I get older, if I become frail, and Evie herself has her back issues, which are going to affect her for the rest of her life, there's no cure for it. We actually have discussed, well, you know, poor Thomas, where does he go if we're both, you know, pretty sick and frail? We don't want him to be stuck looking after us, but we don't know what's going to happen in the future. It's not an exact science, so we don't really know.
Leocadia, do you think about what it'll be like when you're, say, 50 and Des is 84?
I tend not to think about what will happen when Des gets old. I tend to think about the loss more than anything. I tend to think what happens when I lose him. And I'm saddened by the fact that the main thing that bothers me is that we have this huge age gap and I don't have those years with him. Des jokes that he's going to outlive me because he's much more fitter. You know, and there's been times where we've definitely looked at him and gone, oh, heck, what are we doing? You know, there is this big age difference, but our son, Christian, is quite seriously sick. And we've just put, I think, that thought of what happens to us in the future and just gone, we need to put all our energy into our children. If they're happy, then we'll be happy and it will all be fine. And I think that's just what we've carried through with that.
Mm. Des, do you think about it?
yes, definitely. I've told Leocadia what to do with my ashes. But it's something that you can't allow destroy
what you have,
what you're trying to work on at the moment. I think I'm a little bit like my compatriot over here, where I wouldn't want Leocadia to be having to look after me. So I've said, well, just put me over here.
Just park me somewhere.
Park me somewhere. And I can go insane on my own. You know, it's really something that I try and avoid as much as possible by living healthfully and the best I can.
Russell, do you think about the future? Is your relationship at a stage where you think about the future?
I guess I might think about it, but we're at the very early stages of this relationship. I don't think anybody knows what's happening. We're just enjoying each other's company at this stage.
Yeah, we're still in the honeymoon phase and we're just enjoying life together.
So have you talked about anything like having kids or...?
Vaguely.
Yeah.
I mean, he's 19. I'm not particularly wanting to have children. He's 19. I don't think that's something that he has thought about. It's not really a topic that's come up so much. Yeah.
Philippa, do you think about the future, what it might be like with Ryan, say, 20 years' time?
Yeah, I do. I think it would be a lot of fun. Yeah, I think the future is really positive, and when I look into the future, I feel good about it. And I think if anything ever would break us up, it wouldn't be our age gap. It would be something else, I think.
Rye, what about you? Do you think about the future, about what it might be like in 20 years' time when you're, what would you be, say, 40 and Philippa 60?
I still think Philippa would be a very good-looking 60-year-old, so that's comforting. But, of course, you know, you always think about the future, but I've always been taught to live in the present. My mom has always been very strong on that, you know, and just take day by day, and that's very much how I live. I'm a very spontaneous person, and I really focus on the present because, I mean, why? I mean, it's nice to think about the future, but sometimes the future holds a lot of worries. I'm really enjoying my time with Philippa a lot, and, you know, we've managed to find this level lately of communication that is really positive, and the fact that we have that looks like, you know, it could be a very promising future for us both, and I really look forward to living it with Philippa.
Leocadia, how is it with your family now?
Well, my mum is looking after both boys tonight, so that's progressed quite well. I would say that Christian being diagnosed with cancer last year made her change her tune and want to be more involved and so forth. I do have a relationship with my brother and sister, which has taken a lot of time to repair and so forth. But the family's very much Des, myself and the boys. But Mum's definitely changed her attitude and she's very much willing to help out and accept us as much as she can.
Thank you very much for joining us tonight, all of you. Thank you for sharing your lives with us. And that is all we have time for here. But let's keep talking online. You can also watch many past episodes of Insight on SBS On Demand. Thanks for watching. Thanks, everyone. Thank you.